Welcome back to the Arkansas A&M Black Bears Dynasty and the Bear Down Podcast, where it's all about everything Arkansas A&M. And fellas, we are winding down the season right now on the schedule. This is the last regular season game, getting ready to take on Alabama. But first, we got to look back at the week that was. Take a look at the recruiting class. They were award finalists named, and you already know the best part of this podcast, the top five plays from the week. Let's get things started. So we started things off this week with the battle of the natural state as we took on our rival Arkansas State. We won this game 49-35, a lot closer than what some expected. We were able to put up 14 in the first, 21 in the second quarter, 7 in the third, and then 7 in the fourth. Just a great team win. Big day for Gabe Perez through the air, 331 yards, 5 total touchdowns with 2 interceptions. The ground game, of course, Philip Fagan continues to have a monster season, 27 carries, 199 yards with 2 rushing touchdowns. Out wide, Will Rogers led the way. He balled out this game. 6 grabs, 133 yards and 2 scores. You will see probably 2 or 3 plays from Will Rogers in the top 5. I'm not even going to lie to you. Mike Warren, second on the team, 5 catches for 95 yards and a touchdown. Justin Harris had 2 for 27 and a score. And then Dominic Foreman, 1 for 19 and a touchdown. Defensively, it was just a tough day for our boys, giving up 138 yards on the ground and 2 touchdowns to Bowling. David Sims, though, 8 tackles, 5 TFLs. I'm not sure. We got 1 sack with Ben Bowen. Interception with Jonathan Thomas, another sack with Garrett Anderson. Be interested to look at these team stats. 283 yards on the ground. They outrushed us. We outthrew them. They only gave up 200. We only gave up 200 yards passing. Held them to 3 of 8 on third down. 0-2 on fourth down. No, they forced 2 turnovers. We forced 1. 736 yards of total offense, and we held the ball for 21 minutes. Just a great team win. Again, A-State plays us a lot tougher than what the Razorbacks do. If I would have to say, A-State's more our rival than Arkansas. Then we were back out on the road, headed down to Georgia, taking on Georgia Tech, man, and we blew these boys out the water, 66-27. It wasn't even close. 14 in the first, 17 in the second, 14 in the third, and then we put 21 up on them in the fourth quarter. Again, Gabe Perez, 371 yards through the air, 2 touchdowns with an interception. The ground game, Philip Fagan, 17 carries, 120, 4 rushing touchdowns. We had 2 wide receivers go over 100 yards this week. Albert Flowers, 5 catches, 115 and a score. And then Ashton Ryan, 4 catches, 120 and a touchdown. Justin Harris, 4 for 59. Mike Warren, 4 for 38, or 4 for 48. Will Rogers, 3 for 18. And Holloway, 1 for 11. Defensively, the secondary looked awful. We gave up over 400 yards passing to Reed. But David Sims had himself a day. 12 tackles, 2 TFLs, 2 interceptions. And I think he had a pick 6. He did. Sims is showing why he is the best linebacker in the country. James Ramirez, 9 tackles. Bo McGee had 8. Smith had 8. Nick Ginn had 5. Let me say something about Brian Smith. He is showing a lot on special teams. He is our gunner on kickoffs. And he is doing a great job getting down the field and pinning these teams back before they can get to the 20-yard line. Trey Jolly had a sack. Thomas had another interception. Just a great win. Wilson had a sack as well. But again, our secondary played like trash. Gave up 408 yards through the air, 143 yards on the ground. They were 6 of 11 on third down, perfect inside the red zone. But what killed them was the 4 turnovers. We did a great job forcing turnovers this week. We held the ball for 18 minutes. Another great win, man. We're undefeated. Next up, Alabama. But before we can look ahead to the Crimson Tide, here is an updated look at the BCS rankings. Our Black Bears, number one team in the country right now. You've got Texas, the Longhorns, undefeated in at number 2. Georgia State is a shock. They're number 3. They're undefeated at 9-0. Washington is 4 at 9-1. Michigan is 5-10-1. You got Florida State in at 6. Michigan State in at 7. Stanford's in at 8. Arizona is 9. Clemson rounds out your top 10. This would make for an interesting BCS championship if both of these teams, A&M and Texas, can make it to the national championship. We were rivals in the Big 12 for a few years, and to have it come down to these two teams in the last game of the season, that would be a lot of fun. Time to take a look at the stats on the season so far. Gabe Perez, monster year, 3,190 yards, 33 touchdowns, 5 interceptions. He's completing 69% of his balls. Again, Gabe is just showing why he's the best quarterback in college football. I do not expect him to be back for his senior year, especially if we win the national championship. On the ground, Philip Fagan is knocking on the door of 2,000 yards, 248 carries, 1,735 yards, 30 touchdowns, with possibly 3 games left in the season. Can we get Philip Fagan to 2,000 yards? Anthony Bryant, 320 yards and 6 scores. Marquise Powers, 248 and 2 scores. Out wide, Mike Warren leading the team in catches, 45 grabs for 738 yards and 7 touchdowns. Will Rogers, second, 44 catches, 652 and 6 scores. Then you got Albert Flowers, the true freshman, 42 grabs for 765, 10 touchdowns. This freshman is a do-all player, man, and he's doing a great job and is showing why. For the next three seasons, he's going to be wide receiver number one in this offense. Ashton Ryan, fourth on the team, 35 grabs, 631 and 5 scores. You got Justin Harris in his senior year, 22 grabs, 382 and 3 scores. Holloway, 10 for 46 and a touchdown. Powers, 9 for 44. Fagan, 7 for 43. Foreman, 5 for 86 and a score. Lawson, 2 for 51 and a touchdown. And Luke Baker, 1 for 3 and a score. To the defense side of the ball, we go David Sims, the captain, leading the way. 73 tackles on the year, 19 TFLs. I saw a comment on the last video saying that David Sims is the best cover linebacker in college football. That's facts. I think he might even hands down be the best linebacker in college football. He plays all over the field. He can cover tight ends. He can cover running backs. He's going to make the tackle if you need him to. He's just a big play waiting to happen. And he still has one more season at A&M. Nick Ginn in his senior campaign, 46 tackles on the year. Richie Anderson doing a great job playing nickel, corner, and free safety, 41 tackles. James Ramirez getting the first start of the year of his career. James Ramirez with 40 tackles. Bo McGee with 36. Ben Bowen has 35. Then you've got Jonathan Thomas with 33. Jermaine Coco has 30. Chris Johnson with 24. Caleb Walker also has 24. Brian Smith, like I mentioned before, doing a great job on special teams for us. He's got 20 tackles on the year. Trey Turner has 19. Then you got Trey Jolly with 17. And Phil Anderson has 10. Sack department, we're not getting as much pressure. I think it's something to do with the sliders, but that's okay. Caleb Walker, 6 sacks. Garrett Anderson and Trey Turner each with 4. You got Trey Jolly with 2. Wilson, Hendricks, Hester, Coco, Bowen, Sims, each with 1. We're doing a great job forcing turnovers this season. Bo McGee and James Ramirez, 1 and 2, 6 interceptions apiece. Then you got David Sims, third on the team with 5 interceptions. Jonathan Thomas has 3. Jermaine Coco has 3 as well. Nick Ginn with 2. Anderson and Forwarder each with 1. Here's a look at forced fumbles. Trey Turner has 2. Bo McGee, Chris Johnson, Nick Ginn, Jonathan Thomas, Garrett Anderson, and Jermaine Coco each have 1. Then you've got Bowen, Anderson, Richie Anderson, Brian Smith, and Trey Jolly. They've recovered 1 fumble each. And touchdown-wise, we're doing a great job taking those interceptions back to the crib. David Sims with 3 defensive touchdowns this year. James Ramirez has 2. And Nick Ginn has 1. Special teams doing a great job. Keaton Holt, 5 of 5, perfect on field goals this year. 85 for 85 on extra points. Ryan Barnes has 10 punts for 354 yards. He's averaging about 34 yards per punt, which that was a little bit better. In a return game, please don't kick the ball to Marquise Powers. If you kick the ball to Marquise Powers, be ready to be disappointed. 37 returns, 1,553 yards with 5 kickoff returns for touchdowns. He's an explosive player, a dynamic return man, and it's only getting better. It sucks that this is his senior year, but sheesh, stop kicking the ball to him. Punt returns, 18 returns for 286 for Powers. Again, just a dynamic player. He sets us up with great field every time he touches the ball on special teams. And here's a look at the college football leaders through 13 weeks. Gabe Perez, the number one QB in the country as far as yards is concerned, 3,190 yards. Second is Lamb from SMU. Clark from Akron, he's got 2,709. Gillett from Houston, he's got 2,603. And then Collins is fifth from LSU, 25-23. On the ground, Philip Fagan leading the way, 1,735 yards, followed by Coleman from Fresno State, 1,478 yards. Thompson from Oregon having a monster year, 1,442 yards. Hollis from Arizona, 1,351. And Bailey from Tennessee with 1,312. Out wide, not that many wide receivers in 1,000 yards, man. Hughes from Indiana leading the way with 1,107. Clark from SMU, he's got 1,065. Johnson from North Carolina, 1,048. Lee from LSU, who we saw a couple weeks ago, 1,047. You got Estes from Florida State with 989. And then Albert Flowers is 29th on this list with 765. To the defensive side of the ball we go, and it's not a shocker. David Sims leading the country with 70 tackles, followed by Ingram from Purdue with 48. Nick Guinness third on this list with 45. Spence from Ohio State, he's got 44, and then Johnson from Ole Miss with 41. QB sack department, Larson, the true freshman from Alabama, 10.5 sacks. We see him this week. Glover from Hawaii, 9 sacks. Thompson from Washington, 8.5 sacks. Same with Davis from Texas Tech and Hollis from Iowa. They both have 8.5. And then Caleb Walker is 31st on this list with 6 sacks. Interception department, we've got a new leader. Ford from FIU, he's got 7 interceptions. Our cornerback tandem with Ramirez and McGee are tied for second with 6. Deloach from Michigan, he's got 5. And Williams from Western Kentucky, he's got 5 as well. So award finalists were named, and the Black Bears are all over this list. We'll start things off with the Maxwell Award. Philip Fagan leads the way. He's in first place. And then Gabe Perez is third on this list. Then you've got the Walter Camp. Philip Fagan, number one with Gabe Perez down at 6. For the Bednarik, nothing but Black Bears in the top 10. You got David Sims, James Ramirez, Bo McGee, Jermaine Coco, Nick Ginn, Jonathan Thomas, and Richie Anderson, 1-7. The Nagurski, David Sims is first. Then you've got Bo McGee, Ramirez, and Walker at 5, 6, and 7. Trey Turner and Jermaine Coco are 9 and 10. For the O'Brien, I'm not shocked. Hopefully he can hold on to win it. Gabe Perez is number one. For the Doak Walker, again, I'm not shocked. Philip Fagan is the lead vote getter so far. For the Biletnikoff, I was shocked by this. Albert Flowers, the true freshman, with 42 grads for 765 and 10 scores, he's number one on the Biletnikoff list. The Mackey Award, it's a dogfight right now. Jared Ray, from Houston, 41 grabs, 809, and 9 scores. He's number one. But right behind him, Ashton Ryan from A&M, 35 grabs, 631, and 5 scores. The Outland Award, Texas is James Walker at right guard. The Remington, Texas is center Joey Smith. Jonathan Hawkins is 7th on this list. The Lombardi Award, Zach Thomas from Washington. He's number one, followed by true freshman Benjamin Larson. And then you've got our defensive line, Trey Turner, Caleb Walker, and Garrett Anderson, 3, 4, and 5. The Butkus Award, David Sims is number one on this list. I believe he will win this award this year. Ben Bowen is 4th. The Thorpe Award, Iron Tire Secondary is on this list. James Ramirez, Bo McGee, Jermaine Coco, Nick Ginn, Jonathan Thomas, and Richie Anderson, 1-6. Keaton Hope scratches the top 10 for the Groza Award. And then for the Returner of the Year, no shock, Marquise Powers. All right, boys, it's time to get into it. The best part of this podcast, my favorite for sure, is the top 5 plays from the week that was. Let's jump right in, starting off with number 5.
First to 10, 4 wide, trips left. 3.
Got him. Let's go. Let's go, Sims. Come on, Sims. Don't you get caught. Don't you get caught. Let's go. You tried it. You tried it one too many times. David Sims to the house. Touchdown, Bears. You tried it one too many times, sir.
And here's number 4.
Oh, we can make this a 3-score lead real quick. 3-score lead real quick. Come on, Marquise. Great block. Boom. Pancake. Get that block there. Get that block there. Come on, Powers. Come on, Keith. On your horse, baby. To the crib. To the crib, Keith.
Touchdown Bears. I told you he had one. I told you he was going to get one. I can't believe they kicked it to him. Woo. Woo. Oh, I can't believe they kicked it to that man. What are you thinking? Why would you do that? Marquise Powers to the house. This time from 105.
And another one.
Why would you do that?
Number three.
Third and 33. Five wide. See if we can get something here. Miracle time. There it is. There it is. There it is. Flowers to the house. Touchdown Bears. Miracle. Just throw it up. We got you.
Number two.
All right, second and 10. Two tight ends. Twins left. Go get it. Oh! Mike Ward off the tip. Touchdown Bears. Tip ball. Look at Mike Ward. Johnny on the spot.
And the top play from this past week is?
Second and 9. We stay 4 wide. Gabe going to the air. Drops back. Lobs it up downfield. Will Rogers. Oh! What a catch. Touchdown Bears. Will Rogers. Shout out to Gabe Perez breaking RT2's touchdown career passing record. But let's talk about that catch, though. Yo.
So as the season starts to wind down, the recruiting starts to heat up, man. We have 5 players left on our board. Jake Payne from Tennessee. The 4-star athlete, 6'1", 194, is the latest player to commit. Again, this kid is a Swiss Army knife. 94 speed, 82 agility, 95 acceleration. He's got coverage ability, man and zone. Great press, great catching, decent route running. But he also has running back traits. It's going to be interesting to see where coach puts him on the field this year. Honestly, he can play both sides, offense and defense. And he could be an option in the return game. So let's hit the top of the board. The number one player on our board right now is Chad Brown, the fullback from Mississippi. I think he is just coming off a visit to Tennessee. He is, and he has put the Vols as his number one team. It's a 3-team race as of right now, Tennessee, A&M, and Ole Miss. He's got another visit coming up with Ole Miss next week, but I think we can still sign him and get him into the fold. Again, he would make for a great fullback, blocking fullback, and a great third tight end in our offense. On the offensive line, Javon Thomas from Alabama, the 4-star left tackle. Right now, Bama is his number one team over A&M and Nebraska and Notre Dame. He has a visit coming up to Nebraska this week. He is coming off a visit to Florida, it looks like, where he put up 1,350 points. Wow. But they can't even scratch the top 4. A lot of big-name schools wanting this big fella, 6'7", 292. If we could get this race to go into the offseason, I think we have a chance. We have a big lead so far for Jesse Beck, the big guard from Louisiana, 6'4", 292, 4-star prospect. He's got visits coming up to Washington this week and then Florida State next week. And as you can see, his top 3 schools, A&M, Florida State, and Washington. This is another player, if we can get him into the offseason and we can get him committed in the offseason, it would be a great get for our Black Bears. Right now, it's a dogfight for Donnie Brittain, the big center from Louisiana, 6'4", 277, 4-star prospect. He just moved Texas to his number one team, and it's a dogfight between us and the Longhorns. He is coming off a visit to the Longhorns last week, which explains why he has them in the lead right now. We might have to go to the offseason with this one as well. There's going to be a lot of tight races as we wind down the season. And the last player on our board right now is Andrew Morris, the 6'1", 235-pound, 3-star outside linebacker from Rhode Island. Our lead is starting to grow over teams like Notre Dame, Texas A&M, Florida State, and Washington. This is a very fast linebacker, great coverage ability, and great tackling ability. Another great weapon for our defense that is starting to put things together. So with the signing of Payne, that moves us up to number 7 in the top recruiting classes. 10 prospects already committed with 5 left on our board. Mississippi State starting to run away with things, man. 20 recruits already. The Bulldogs looking stacked going into next season. Then you've got Auburn in at number two. Bama, top three. Florida is in at four. Vandy is at five. Washington at six. Got A&M at seven. Clemson is eight. USC is nine. And Michigan State in at 10. Look at this, man. One through five. All SEC. Fellas, I can't even sugarcoat it. This is going to be the biggest game of the season. Our Black Bears close out the regular season on the road, getting ready to take on Alabama. Now, this Bama squad, they're underperforming this year, but they are stacked across the board. A very dominant offensive line. We're going to be in trouble with their run game. Defensively, Benjamin Larson, as a true freshman, is putting up incredible sack totals. I think they have a solid defensive line, but their linebackers definitely shine through. And then their secondary is just fast, elite speed at all levels. It's going to be a scary game for us. We're on the road in Tuscaloosa. We have to come with our A game. Dennis Ingram is going to be a problem. Great arm. He can get outside the pocket. He's been hurt, so he's been in and out of the season. But look at his throw power and his accuracy. This kid is something special, and he's only a sophomore. But luckily for us, they'll be missing a lot of key players this week. Troy Diggs at wide receiver. He'll be missing 3 weeks with broken ribs. Then you've got Mike Johnson on the defensive line. He's also missing 3 weeks with a broken tailbone. And outside linebacker Corey Medlock, he will be out with a torn shoulder for 5 weeks. Now, that's a lot of help for our offense. Let me be honest with you. Johnson looks like a terror, and Medlock plays all over the field. If we could take advantage of them somehow, it'll probably be through the run game, which will help open up the short passing game for Gabe Perez this week. So, fellas, that's going to do it for the podcast. Our final game of the regular season on the road, taking on the 6-4 Alabama Crimson Tide. I think this is game of the year. This should be game of the year. A lot is on the line here. Win, and we're going to the SEC championship. Lose, and we might end up missing out on the national championship. This will be a fun one, man. If you guys enjoyed this video, make sure you smash that thumbs up button. Subscribe if you're brand new. Don't forget to ring that bell. Join the Noti Squad. And make sure you guys check out those links down in my description. Follow your boy on Facebook, Twitter, and IG. And come through and join the Discord fam for exclusive content. And we'll talk from Tuscaloosa as we take on the 6-4 Crimson Tide. Have a great day, guys. Two fingers in the air. Peace. Big thank you to all the members of the channel and the Patreons. If you would like to become a member or a Patreon, hit the links down below in my description.